Hello everyone, welcome to the Engineering Projects YouTube channel. In this video tutorial we will discuss about Web API controller. In my previous video tutorial I have already created a Web API with MVC project and discuss about how we can test Web API. In this we will learn about the controller of Web API in depth. In the controller folder here you will find these controllers, okay, and these are the controller of API kind, okay. These tools are of MVC and this is for API, and you can observe here is the API controller. The value controller is extended by the API controller, that's why it's API controller. And when I click on home controller, it's extended by only with the controller, that's why it is the normal controller. And when you want to create a controller for Web API, you have to extend that with API controller class, okay. This is the default API controller. You can simply create your own controller by right click here and click on add. Okay, here is the controller and you have to select that API controller empty or API controller whatever you want the specification, and click add and it will be added into your controller folder. I will not add a new controller here, I will discuss this controller only, okay. As you can see, value controller class derive from API controller and include multiple action method whose name match with HTTP verbs, like here is the get, okay, HTTP get, or the name is get, and here is TEP, here is the name get, post, put, delete, and that's it. Web API decide which verb API controller and action method to be execute. The get method will handle HTTP get request and post method will handle post request and so on. Put delete will do their respective requests. Here let me illustrate the basic purpose. Here is the base controller of Web API and here is the sample get method. Whenever the get request will be forwarded, it will get called, okay, and when a request, and here is the get request for TEP, the custom method I have created, and whenever the get request will be sent in the name of TEP, it will be called, okay. And it is a simple difference here and so on. This is the post get request with some ID. Here is the value of API and API values forward slash something else and so on like this. Now what I will do before I will execute this application, you must have to understand the naming convention. If you are giving the naming convention as the HTTP request, then it will automatically understand what they have to be do with that request. Like this get request automatically understand if the variable or the attribute will be in the get format, it will be called. Else if it will be in post method, then this will be called. Now I will execute this application in my Firefox, okay. And let's see what will be the result of this, okay. Now here you will observe we have to call the forward slash API forward slash values to get this, okay, to get the values from here. And same here, we have to use the HTTP GET method for this. Remember that when we have two methods with the same param and same naming convention, okay, and the only one will called which have the HTTP specific naming convention or method will be called, such as here we have two method get and TEP with the same interior, but I have here action filter HTTP get. So when I will call the get data, this action listener will be called. Let me copy this and wait until it will execute successfully. Now it's execute successfully. So what I will do, I will paste the link here and now execute. So it's returned me the error on this controller. Okay, I have error on this controller. Now what I will do, I will call something else like this. Okay, I will call this and it will return me content value. Okay, it's return the content value. Now I will change value into ID. Let me pause it. Okay, it's pause, and now ID dot to string, and here we're done. Save it, continue. Okay, refresh the browser and the value will be changed. Now whatever the value is in the numeric form, it will be represented here. I hope this video tutorial is informative for you. If you have any kind of question regarding this, you can ask us, and don't forget to subscribe the engineering project for getting more knowledge about ASP.NET MVC application development. Take care. Bye bye.